And whoever needs, I have pages up here. We're going to try to attempt to come from a place of strength today. Mamash. Big video of the fixing of everything from strength. Mikoach. We're going to march towards this koach. The strength of Am Yisrael. I'm telling you, it's there. The strength is in the people. It's bubbling and emerging. It's like an unbelievable thing. I'll share with you a very amen. I saw, listen. I'm recapping right now the last 2 days for myself, just going and trying to strengthen myself tremendously. And I was Baruch Hashem, I was just privileged to be with so much of Am Yisrael in the last 2 days. Well, late on the night of Yom HaTzmaut, I have something every year that I wasn't going to do this year, but they changed it from, it was too small in the first station, and they had changed it to Liberty, what's it called? Liberty Bell. Yeah, Liberty Park, Liberty Bell Park, which goes down the park. I'm sorry? Yeah, people are starving. People are, you know, so thirsty, and I was not going to do it this year because of a number of reasons, but the main one was like, everything has to be rethought and reconfigured, even the way that we approach these days. The way we commemorate, the way we mourn, and the way we celebrate all have to be part of the revamping, all part of just mamash, control, alt, delete, and madchala, right? Now, but the truth is that actually is happening to a certain extent, and I feel that the ones that are leading the road to that are Nebuch, unfortunately, the bereaved families, and especially the ones that, and there's no judging, God forbid, because everyone goes through it in their own way, but especially the ones that have been able to take their personal stories and put it in the context of the historic time of shift that's within Am Yisrael. So you have some of the, you know, parents and siblings of people that have lost people. It's just their koyach and their determination. It's this lo me'olam hazeh. So when I found out that the mother of Binyamin Ehrli, Jen Ehrli, was going to be the one that is opening the whole event, and then I realized, hey, listen, if she's going to be there, and I know her, I've gotten to know her the last few months. If she's going to be there and she's going to set the tone, then who am I to say? No, I have, you know, not this year.
It means a lot. It means a lot. You give a lot of chizik to all those people.
Yeah, but I, no, listen.
I'm not saying it's easy.
You can always give chizik. Today you can give chizik in many different ways. And honestly, other people. I even had someone else set up. I'm a shadach with someone else. But then I was getting pressure from the top. And it was the right thing to do. And I saw Am Yisrael there that, again, that I've never saw people cry while they're dancing. People were crying while they were dancing. It was something I never saw before. And then I felt very strong about the shul yesterday morning. I felt, it just shows you that it's never about numbers, chavra. I never get extra exhilarated and excited when it's mobbed up there. I'm thankful that there's a place for people that want to be part, but Rav Weinberger told me a long time ago, never, if you want to know how to like build properly in a healthy way, never count talesim, he said. Never count talesim. So I felt, also I had a very special hachana, I'm just sharing with you. I actually sat with Rav Weinberger for a few hours right before the Yom HaTzmaut, right before the thingy in Gan HaPa'amon. He's in Yerushalayim. So again, for me personally, it just got my, you know, the focus, the screws back on. And then, yeah, so again, so the shul yesterday was just very, I came home and was just feeling Hazarim B'dima Berina, Yiktzaru, all together. Everyone was just really there. Whoever was there was, I felt totally, fully, fully there. Knowing that this has to be different. None of us know what that really looks like. But if you show up with an open heart before HaKadosh Baruch Hu, then Savir Laniach, you could rely on the flow coming out in a proper way. And then I'll just, one more thing, because this is just another pan of Am Yisrael, because I was just with so much of Am Yisrael. Last night, I'm very close to one of these, one of the most beautiful Yidden I know. It's Hanan Ben Ari. And he put on these massive concerts two nights ago and last night, just for Chayalim.
What was it?
It was in Tel Aviv. And he asked me to come and daven with him and be there with him, and I brought my daughter. And you have to realize, like, walking in, you see people that just came out of Rafiach that morning. You see, there was a whole section of Pitzuim there, people that are in wheelchairs, people. And everyone there are kids that came with their father that's been in Miluim for months. I think they tapped it at 6,000 in one of these just massive halls. And you see Am Yisrael that is not ignoring the situation by going to an event like that and being like, no, tzchim adayin lachgog. It wasn't like that. The number of days that the hostages are still in captivity was on the stage. The whole notion was like, again, hazorim bedima berina. It's like literally back and forth with this dance of crying and singing. This is Am Yisrael, Zeh Mashu Chadash. This is something new. And it's emerging from within the Chevra. And I feel even stronger now that we're coming here and we're trying to learn something that we can now hopefully live, but also give over as an alternative to people whose hearts are wide open, right. And they're just for Am Yisrael. They're all chayalim for Am Yisrael. All chayalim for Am Yisrael, and they need direction. The light and the determination is all there, and which brings us to today, because now it's a matter of what kind of da'at are we giving over, the da'as, right? So I actually feel really, really, really proud, more proud than ever, but also more, like what you said, Yosef, like mamash, that this on like how you were leading up to the strength, the weakness from mitzad, the people that have been making decisions, but that's nothing in comparison to the strength that's coming from within the people. You know, 50,000 people marched down towards Gaza on Yom Ha'atzmaut.
Really?
Yes.
I was there.
You went? Yeah. Wow. Ashrecha. Was it Geuladik? Was it?
Yeah, it was great.
Geuladik, yeah.
It's like, there's a lot of families.
Yeah, I saw some video, I saw some pictures.
Inside Gaza?
No. From Sderot, right? Sderot. Yeah, Sderot.
Through Sderot, and
it's amazing.
We got to talk to people from Sderot, that was also quite special.
Who had to run for shelter on Yom Ha'atzmaut from another barrage of...
They all did.
We all saw it right in the middle of the whole thing.
Yeah.
We're walking in.
Unbelievable.
Three iron domes, boom, boom,
unbelievable.
Boom.
Really?
There was no sirens. Just
and you continue walking. And you know that we're getting better when you know, Hashem sends people like Yishai Fleischer to go on Piers Morgan yesterday to...
Did you see it?
I saw a few pieces of it, yeah. I didn't see the whole thing. I saw a few clips.
How was it?
It's Yishai in his best.
Yishai
was shut.
It's hard for me to watch.
Yeah. You're nervous.
Yeah.
Of course, it's mamish the lions then and there. Yeah. You know, mamish the lions then.
If there's anyone in the world that should be there, it's Yishai.
It's Yishai. That's what I'm saying. It's like Hashem. What are you? It's amazing.
I just was hoping Hashem would bless him to bring his best there. And it's,
I felt that mamish, and he's going up against mamish. A yid,
the darkest.
One of the darkest self-hating yidden of our times, Norman Finkelstein.
Wow.
So it'll. I think the whole thing will come out later today. But if there's people like that are speaking about Am Yisrael, it makes me feel, wow, more and more, just give me more and more of that. Yehudim shelo mebulbalim, not confused yidden. Listen, the 6,000 people last night that I was with, none of them were confused. None of them were confused. Loma bulbalim. We're trying to stay focused, not lidbalbel. And today we had done chokhmah and bina, and now we're moving forward towards daat. So we should have a lot of Seyed Dishmaya in this next chapter, because this is it's just a very chazak approach. Also, Jeremy should have a refuah shlema bezrat Hashem. And today, the sponsorships of today is done by the Goldsmith Mishpacha, by Eli and Masha Goldsmith, and the zchut and the safety of their son. Baruch Yitzchak ben Masha v'Eliyahu, Eliezer HaKoyen, and all the Chayalim HaKadoshim of Am Yisrael, who are on the front lines to complete a healthy victory, Be'ezrat Hashem. The week is also sponsored by Drs. Yonatan and Shira Wiesen, for the Fuhu Shlem of Leah Shoshana Basmalia, by the Orenstein Mishpacha, dedicated to Sarah Orenstein on Milestone Birthday Week, and by Regina Warshavsky in honor of her brother, Reb Chaim Shlomo, Dr. Warshavsky's special birthday, Mazel Tov, Ad Me'a Ve'esrim. Also the month, sorry, I'm going backwards today. The month of Iyar is in commemoration of the Yahrzeit of Nachon Shimon ben Reb Yitzchak Aryeh Kram. That's Dov's father, precious Abba, and Ira Brown and family in memory of Ira's grandfather, Eliezer ben Meir, Zichron Levracha. Okay, Chevra, Daf Samechet, chapter 7, in Tikkun HaMedina, Perek Zayin, Das. We would all live to be a bar das, someone that's walking with das, with that means infinitely more than knowledge, right? Infinitely more, much infinitely deeper than just the concept of knowledge. And when I say dat, and you want to sound a little bit deep, where's the first place you're going to go to understand the concept of dat in the Torah? I'm giving you 5 seconds before. Before that.
Adam,
I want to say Bereishis Bara Elokim Sashmayim, whatever. I was pulling you there's a whole gematria with Das and Bereishis Bara Elokim Sashmayim, but obviously, Ve'adam Yada Et Chava Ishto. The concept of Das, the way that it shows up through Eitz Hadas, and the way that it shows up through Adam and Eve, represent for us a whole world of connecting to the world of Dat in a way that we're not used to. We say that when Adam knew Eve, what does that mean? When we say he biblically knew her, that he was intimate with her, which means that Das, in its core, is about being intimate and close to that which your Chochmah and Bina has already panned out for you. Dat is being intimately close to the Birurim that you did through Chochmah and Bina. But does that mean that I'm supposed to be close to the tree of knowledge, Eitz Hadas? Well, we're going to see what this means, okay? But it's important for us to first, he's going to do a quick recap. We haven't learned in 10 days this Sefer. We're first going to do a quick recap of what we ended off with, and then continuing forward, going weiter. We should have a lot of atzlochan right now. Das, Yichudo shel Am Yisrael. Acharei shehunchu yesodot ha-chokhma ve-abina. After we have laid out and really connected to the foundations of what chokhma and bina are, which basically mean ha-hakara besamchut ha-torah, recognizing the total authority of the Torah being the only authority in our lives, especially as a nation living in Eretz Yisrael, the Torah and nothing else. Ubeichrech, which brings about shalosh hashlemuyot. Remember this? We brings about the three completions, the three things that have to be complete. Shlemus haTorah, shlemus haAm, the shlemus haAretz. Anu ponim el tchunat hadat. Now we're turning towards das. Shelo kechokhma vebina, as opposed to what chokhma and bina are and how they operate. Moach hadat einenu rak koach sichli. This is important. The intellect of Das is not just an intellectual, a brainy koyach strength. Vehu meshamesh kememutza ben haseichel leven rikshot halev. It serves as a memutza. You know what a memutza means?
An average.
So average is the modern, is a more modern understanding of the word memutza. But here, well, I want to see how in the English, Reb Shlomo Vial, do you have it in you, the word memutza, how the Rav says it in English? Would he say an integration?
It connects it to the emotion to the heart. That's not really the same
thing. Well, it's not really the same thing. Yeah. Memutza, average over here, it really means a complete blending, a complete merger between the mind.
Integration.
I think that's a better word. Between the mind and the feelings of the heart. Remember, the first thing we did when we walked in here October 8th is that we said, we are not going to be letting our hearts right now be the ones that are leading us through getting through this time. Why? Why not? We would go crazy. Mamash, we would go crazy. So what did we end up doing for 2 months? We spent 2 months learning Perek Yud Beis and Or HaRayon of Rav Kahana about Nekama through the sources, through Torah. It wasn't this thing of, let's finally time. No, it's Dafka Yidin. The way we hopefully conduct ourselves is that we must integrate, we must bring in the Das of Torah and for it to merge with all the Rikshot HaLev, with all the feelings of the heart. That's what Das does, he says to us. Well, he's going to explain this further, because it's important for us to differentiate between Chochma and Bina and the world of Da'at. La Chochma, in the fourth line, La Chochma ofi shel klita milamala, ptichut. Chochma has this characteristic trait of receiving from above, an openness to receive from above. Chochma. I'm just open to receive something from above. Lebina. Yes, ofi shel harchava veyicholet berur atzmi. Bina has the ability of harchava, expansion, taking that thing that I was open for to receive from above, and to expand it, and berur atzmi. What does berur atzmi mean?
Personal sifting.
Self-clarification, right, personal sifting. Taking all this light, taking all the wisdom that's coming through, expanding it, and then making it a berur atzmi. Like really null of, like self, it's a weird thing, this self-sifting, but to just clarify.
You get it better, self-clarification.
I think it's self-clarification is a better way of saying this. Das, ofi nafshi yoter, bepachot sichli. Das is a more, what does that mean, nafshi yoter?
Soul.
It's more soulful and less brainy, which is so weird because we always look at das as Lemaisa. Lemaisa, which and when we say Lemaisa, we usually mean Yala. What are we actually doing? Huh? Tachlis, right? But the Tachlis over here is Dafka something that has more of a soulful manifestation than it does in a practical way. And he's gonna explain everything we just said right now. Still doesn't mean we'll understand anything, but at least he'll explain it. He maf'ila et kochot ha-nefesh. The Das activates all the kochos of the soul, b'ma'amatz lehitrakez ulitmaked me'od batochen ha-sichli shenimsa'ela min ha-kochot she'me'aleha, with an attempt to lehitmaked, the word, the million-dollar word we keep on saying over here, to focus very much on all the intellectual context that has been given to her from above. It's trying to take all the Chochmah and Bina, all the content, and to focus in on and zone in on all this Koach that's received from above. B'ma'amatz hazeh, even the attempt, the pursuit of this, choret et maskanot ha-sechel aluach ha-lev. I love this wording. It inscribes or engraves the maskanot. Maskana, the conclusions of the brain, where does it inscribe it on? Where does it engrave it on? Luach HaLev. On the board of the heart. It's an amazing thing. You'd think, I have to engrave in my seichel what my heart feels. But this is classic Chabad. Moach Shalit Al HaLev. That means the heart is being governed through the moach, so that things are done in the most holiest, calculated way. He's saying even thinking about and really focusing on looking at all that's come through Chochmah and Bina, Rav Ginsburg is saying just the ma'amat to focus it it leads its maskanot. You always say, like, there's going to be all these va'adot chakira, which means all of these investigations, right? And there's going to be what's called yisum maskanot. That means the implementation of the conclusions, right? So the way it works here with our kochos and nefesh is that how do you even know what to do? Where does it get engraved? On the luach of the lev. Through what? Through the hitbonenut pnimit, through deep introspection, that of all that's come through chokhmah and bina, meaning, let's try to bring it down to our terminology for a second. When I learn and I bring myself back to the three shlemuyot, shlemut ha'am, shlemut ha'torah, v'shlemut ha'aretz, and the fact that the only authority, the only authoritative notion for Am Yisrael anywhere, but specifically in Eretz Yisrael, is a word we're always so scared to say because it sounds so radical, which is what? Torah. Rav Weinberger told me a great line the other day. He said something like this. Yiddishkeit can't exist without Yiddishkeit. Think about this for a second. Do you hear what he said? Yiddishkeit can't exist without Yiddishkeit. That means, is this country about Yiddishkeit or not? If it is, it can't exist without Yiddishkeit.
It's not Jewish.
You can't say that. That's a horrible... Someone got very mad at me. I was having a conversation with someone recently that you know very well. And that word ish is Jewish is very problematic. Because we don't mean anything wrong by saying that, right? I'm Jewish versus
I'm a Jew.
What's the difference? I'll tell you what it's like. I'm marriedish. No, you're married.
The Black Hebrew said, you're Jewish, one who acts like a child is childish. So one who acts like a Jew is Jewish.
Amazing, it comes from them, right? Yeah. I'm frumish? No. Right? This ish is problematic, so...
You got Hamish.
Ham. What? Ham, yeah.
Spanish and Swedish, too.
Huh?
It can be Spanish and Swedish,
yeah?
It doesn't work quite so.
So we have to really zone back in over here and saying, the more that I keep on coming back over and over again through the Chochmah and Bina, that what? The only authority here is the Torah. And that it's dependent, in order for that to be real, it's dependent on Shlemut Haaretz. Shlemut Haaretz. The whole country. The whole land. And you know that that's much more than even the current boundaries and borders today, obviously. But it must start from there. And the Torah, and the Am, not giving up on one person in Am Yisrael. The more that I keep on going back to that more and more and more, then what he's saying over here, that becomes the maskanot, the conclusions of what that means, lemaise, becomes engraved on the board of my heart. And then what does it do? Umakebo galim. It hits it, it makes waves in it. Hapoalim et peulatam, which causes them to do what they have to do in the world. Umevi'im lidei maise, and they come to maise. See, we always want to run to the maisa. That's how we're trained, right? That's kind of how we're
wired.
We want to run to the maisa. And we've run to the maisa for 76 years, running to the maisas. If it's going to come out in a way that has the long lasting, the eternal lasting kavanas of why we're even here in the first place, there's got to be a mahalach here, chaver. There's got to be something thought out here. It's got to be that I see a picture that has kivunim, that it makes sense. It flows down and it goes somewhere. Now, das, and he says, and that is called das. It's a little bit different than just saying knowledge, right? Like I said, I'm getting a shir. That's das, right? That's das. Like, does anyone, let me ask a very obvious question. Does anyone here feel that anyone here, in any top ranking state and top ranking status, is poel with das?
No.
Do they mean well?
No.
I want to do a kav schus now. Bemet, yeah. It's very hard for me to do a kav schus. I want to say most of the time that to them, that's really bemet, even if it's completely against what you and I think. I believe that somewhere deep inside of them, they actually do think that what they're doing is the best thing.
Okay.
I'm talking about like the most right wingers. I'm not talking only about the left. I'm saying even those that, so to speak, are kivyachol, representing more of a world that we're more accustomed to.
That's the scariest part.
Because there's no real da'at. First of all, there's no chokhmah and bina. That's where it starts from. There's no chokhmah and bina.
There's no
chokhmah and bina. There's no beginning of interpreting, of understanding what the Torah is. So therefore, there's no das. There can't be das. You can't do something out of real das if it's not rooted, if it's not coming from chokhmah and bina. There's no way. So I think that this is the path towards, like, really the words of this sefer, Tikkun HaMedina. And I'm still, like, really, like, just... I still see the way that, you know, when I was by Rav Ginsburg a few months ago with Ari and with Jeremy and with another very holy warrior in the front lines of Am Yisrael today, Nati Rom. And I brought up the name of someone who I thought maybe would be a good prospect for leading Am Yisrael, and he's very involved in the political worlds. And Rav Ginsburg didn't brush him off, but he turned to me and he said, "We have to take control over this whole country. We have to take control over the country." Now, when the tzaddik says that, what do you think he means? Do you think he means we need to get the right people in the right places and just storm in? Not be dumb. We have to take control over the country through chokhmah bina v'das. And only someone that could operate from these places can be the one that can lead us to the place that we've been dreaming of. Like Reb Shlomo told us in that piece, the Avram Avinu Zionism, the V'techazena Einenu B'Shulchan Letzion Zionism. Now, let's continue learning. We'll just do, what time is it right now?
40.
Okay, we'll just do one more paragraph, because this is heavy stuff, and I want to make sure that we start off very strong and very clear. Bazohar, don't run out. Zohar, Nikris Hadas, and you have a beard and you have kids. Huh?
This is how you keep me coming back.
Right, this is how I keep you here. I have to know where I'm talking. Zohar, Nikra Hadas, Mafteicha de Kolil Shis, which means Mafteach Shekolel Shesh, which means a key that includes within it six. Mafteach de Kolil Shis. What does that mean? Biotaha Mafteach, it's the key. שעל ידו יכולה ההתבוננות השכלית לפתוח ולעורר את שש מידות הלב. So he's saying that the das is the key through which all of the deep intellectual introspection can open and awaken the six midot of the heart, which we've already learned a few times, but all of the regashot we spoke about ahava and yira, all those things, Das comes and says, okay, so here's the key to unlock how this thing all merges and works together. All these midot of the heart, for you to do it in a way that's miyushav, that's settled, for you to take all those emotions in the heart through the deep introspection that we're thinking about them intellectually and know what to do with it. You ever go to like a therapist and not really understand what he's saying to you, but you know it sounds smart, so you feel better? It's almost like this, okay? Like you feel better thinking, it sounds rationally and emotionally healthy. This must be good. I came to the right place. You understand? Like, even though it hasn't sunk in yet, but this is a little bit of what we're talking about. Hada'at, what does da'as do? Meyaledet, it gives birth. Et regshot. Mitoch haSechel, it gives birth. Adat mi'aledet adat regashot mitoch haSechel. We want our emotions to be thought out emotions coming from a holy intellect, right? It gives it birth. That's what the da'as do. Chochma and Bina has it brewing inside in a holy way. Das gives it birth to come out into the world. And Das itself, to get you even more confused, Hi Atzma Nechleket Lishnei Chalakim. Das is divided in two ways, into two departments. Shekol Echad Hu Shoresh Le'anaf Ikari Shel Regesh. Each one is a root of a main branch of emotion. Now, this is going to help us understand now, when we talk about Yamin U'Smol, left and right, Chesed V'Gvura. But when we say Yamin U'Smol,
small to Yamin, which I found to be very interesting.
On the top.
He didn't say it.
Because he goes back to small Yamin in a second. Yeah. Yamin U'Smol. So what's Yamin? Is it Chesed or Gvura? Small? Gvura. Let's understand this. Hatzada Yemani Shebadat, the right branch of Das, Hi Yediat Vakarat HaTov, is knowing and recognizing the good. Hameluve B'Meshicha Rikshit El Kol Davar Tov, which basically brings about this very emotional magnetism, attraction to anything that's good. I sense that something is good. I feel that something is good. I know that something is good. It brings about a karat tov. I recognize the good. I'm drawn there. That's what Yamin does. Hatzad asmali, left, shebadat, hu yediyat hakara, veyediyat vehakarat hara. Left is also very important, what left represents. It's knowing that that is bad for me. I have to call it out. And I need both. I need to know what's bad, and you know what's good. Now, according to David HaMelech, what's the mahalach of life? Is it small v'yamin or yamin v'small? Based on Tehillim, what do you think? The most famous pasuk in the world, Mi'aish Chofetz Chaim. But think, continue the sentence and tell me, is the mahalach small v'yamin or yamin v'small? Very good. Netzor l'shon chamira, sur mira is small, Va'asei tov is yamin. You understand? Understand this better now? So again, hatzad ha-smali shebadat hu yediyat v'akarat hara, hameluveh af hi b'chush shel slidat tivit mikol ma she'ena tov, which brings about developing a natural slida, deviation. But it really means here like a natural rejection even, or always naturally being turned off and moved away by that which I come to know is bad for me. Yatzoledet bom, that means in Hilchos Shabbos, right? What does that mean, Yatzoledet bom? So what's my natural knee-jerk reaction to it? Right, I pull away. He's saying part of this avoda of what we're doing over here in this work is that we become people that the small and the yamin are healthy and they work properly. That which is going to burn me and burn my people, I don't have to even think about it too much. Why? Because I'll naturally, as if I'm touching a flame, right? But that's gewalt. I could know all that, but like I always give a great mashal, a guy can go out with 300 women while he's looking for his wife, and they're all wrong. They're all the wrong ones. And a shmendrik is happy. Why? You ask him, why are you so happy? He's like, fuck, gewalt. I know exactly what's not for me. That's beautiful. What about yamin? What about knowing what is for you? Whatever, it's not that important. Yes, it is. If the point is getting married, it's great that the small is working, but you got to know what the yamin is. It sounds funny. I'm telling you, I've been there. I've been there with people. Like I see it. Like they know exactly what's not for them, and it makes them feel happy. Okay, it's great. But what is for you, right? This character development that Rav Ginsburg is bringing us through, he has explained to us, das is when small and the yamin are working in unison. And they're working in harmony. Because life is etz das tovara. Olam hazeh. And I'm trying to get to beyond that etz, right? Nachon. Lishnei tzadim elu romez ha-katuv etz das tovara. And this is basically our introduction into the world of das. When the Torah talks about etz das tovara, it's amazing that the first interaction we had with Shmuel Bimin, what was the result of it? First interaction we have with Shmuel Bimin. Shmuel disguised itself as Yamin, and Yamin didn't have a chance to really come out right. Right? Because Shmuel, which should have been, you know, the knee-jerk reaction to the Nachash should have been, but there was no Chochmah and Bina. There was the Chochmah and Bina wasn't there enough. It wasn't there yet. So there wasn't this introspection that led me to this notion of I have to. And in life, there's Etz HaDaas coming up all the time. So again, Daas, just to begin this process over here, will lead us to a place when first the Chochmah and Bina are set, and certain things are clear. Samchut HaTorah, authority of the Torah, Shlemut HaAm, Shlemut HaAretz, Shlemut HaTorah, operating from there, the Yisum Maskanot, the implementations of the Maskanas will be written and engraved in my heart, through Das, the more I go back to this all the time, which will then lead me to naturally be drawn to call out Sheker when it's Sheker and move away from it, and to invite in Emes whenever I see it as well. And that kind of, that's harmony, that's living in, that's basically what's called Yichud. That's what's called the unification of both sides. The Yichud, L'shem Yichud. Bringing it both together and living with it in harmony. We should be zocher to really take this das very seriously, this chapter, and have it show up in every area of our life. Amen.